Hello students, now in this series of video practicals in file handling, this is the third program that we are learning, wherein we will going to append in this program a content of one file to the content of another file. Means first file will contain some data, second file will contain some data. Now to the destination file we are going to append the content of source file. So I will show you that with the help of live demonstration. So as you all know, we are running the code block here to run our C programs because we are using Windows 10. So we are preferring code blocks instead of preferring for Turbo C. So let's begin with here. We are in the code blocks and I have created my project FileHand2. So already I have told you the process that how to create a project in code blocks. So what I am doing over here, see, I am taking three different header files like stdio.h, conio.h, whose functions I am using in the program, and also as we are doing with the file handling. So I am using stdlib header file. Now let's begin with the program. Int main, I am writing the main function, and I am taking here two file pointers because there is a source file and there is a destination file which I am supposed to use in my program. And in that particular case, what I am doing is I am taking a character. So these are some variables that I am taking, fname1 and fname2. So I am printing the statement that enter the source file name, and here I am just scanning that source file with the variable name that I have taken just now. I am now printing enter the destination file name. So again I am scanning that file. Now see what I am doing. Using file pointer 1, I am opening the first file in the read mode. I am opening the first file in the read mode, means source file I am opening in the read mode. And fp2, using the file pointer 2, I am opening the destination file in the append mode. Append mode means what? Here the contents can be appended. Here the contents can be appended in case of destination file. So if file pointer 1, if file pointer 1 is equals to null, or if file pointer 2 is equals to null, this is the error kind of a situation that may arise. So I am going to print out that unable to open the file. If any of the file pointer is null, then I am going to print that unable to open the file, and this becomes the unsuccessful execution. Now I am writing the exact logic of my program, wherein what I am writing, see, do ch is equals to f get c fp1, then I am taking the contents of the first file here, and what I am doing, see, f put c ch comma fp2. So what is the logic that I am writing here? You can just observe that I am reading the contents of file 1 and I am putting those file contents into the another file. So while ch is not equals to end of the file, so this will going to happen till the end of the file. All the contents of the source file will be copied into the destination file, and I will just print the message on the console that the data is copied. And whatever pointers that I have used here, I am closing all those pointers and I am returning 0. So I would like to show you that what are the source and destination files, that is the text files that I have created in my operating system. So this is the file hand 2. You can see the location. This is the project in which I am writing my current program. So here I have created the source file. I am showing you the contents of the source file. The contents of the source file are, this is the source file. Now I am showing you the contents of destination file. This is the destination file. This is the content of the destination file. So let's begin with the execution of the program. And as I have told you that here is a build. So you can build your source code. And here you can run, from here you can run your code. So I am running. So here it is asking me that enter the source file name. So I am typing the source file name as source.txt, because my source file was source.txt. So enter the destination file name, destination.txt. So I have entered the source file name and I have entered the destination file name. Now see what is the output that I am getting. I am getting the message as an output that data is copied. So I will now, I need to see that what has happened to my file that I have created as a text files. So let's go there and see in file hand 2. So let's refresh it. So source file, the contents of the source file are, this is the source file, and the contents of the destination file are, see, this is the destination file, this is the source file. So this is the output that I have got. I have appended the contents of the source file to the destination file by using this particular program. And this is what is the last program in the series of file handling.